Good morning, everyone. I am Brittany Masick and just wanted to welcome you back to Mental Health Mondays. I know we've been on a little bit of a hiatus over the holidays, but wanted to kick off this week with this short video just to hopefully share some words of inspiration and insight with you. So today, I wanted to take a minute to talk about self-care and how to get through these next few winter months when it can be really challenging, right? We just came off of a hopefully great holiday season where there was always something to look forward to, right? Whether it was the decorating and the glow of the Christmas lights, or it was the baking, or it was wrapping presents, or it was being able to have a visit with family and friends safely, whatever it may be. During the last part of the year, from like October to December, there's always excitement and fun things to look forward to throughout those months. But then we get to January and February and things seem to slow down a little bit. It's gray and dark when you wake up. It's gray and dark when you go home from work, or when you're off of work if you're working from home. And it's just, the days can be really monotonous. The days can be really boring. So how do we care for ourselves during these next few months especially? So self-care was, I think, more of a trendy word a couple years ago, and people threw it around loosely. And sometimes there's a misconception about what self-care really is. So self-care, quite simply, is taking care of yourself and doing things that give you energy versus things that drain you. So there are different types of self-care depending on what your needs are. So there can be physical self-care, emotional self-care, and mental health self-care. And it's important, I think, to have a balance of all three. So I'm pulling some of this information from an article I read in an online magazine that was written by a licensed marriage and family therapist. So I'll link the article in the comments after this video is posted. But physical self-care includes the basics like hygiene. So even if you're working from home, getting up and taking a shower every day, brushing your teeth, you know, eating right, exercising, getting the right amount of sleep, all those things I think are a great thing to remember, especially as we're in this new year, we have New Year's resolutions and goals, and just to keep those things at the forefront of our minds. Emotional self-care includes more social components. So making an effort to be with friends. I know for me personally, just over the weekend, I realized I haven't really seen or talked to one of my girlfriends in a while. And so I immediately texted her, can we plan something? So whether that's, you know, a Zoom call, a phone call, whatever you need to do to have that time. I know, you know, there are different game nights people can do online and virtually. Jackbox Party Games has great activities for families and friends to do together safely and socially distant, you know, from your own homes. I know another coworker of mine who does Amazon watch parties with friends. So they all, through Amazon Prime, watch the same movie and then have an opportunity to discuss it, you know, virtually afterwards. So just doing those little things to make sure you're taking care of your emotional self, okay? And the other thing that this therapist talked about was lowering your expectations. And not that you shouldn't have standards for yourself, but that sometimes we put too much pressure on ourselves and then we can't maintain that level of pressure and we just get overwhelmed and anxious and we become our own worst enemy. So lower those expectations. For me, that means not putting my work email on my phone because I need that balance and I need that self-care. So that's one thing I do personally. You will find what works for you. And then lastly, we have mental self-care. So those are things like reading, journaling, listening to a podcast, those types of things, okay? So like I said, winter can be one of the toughest times, especially here in the Midwest, because it's not only dark and dreary, but it's also cold and snowy and icy. And sometimes we get that all in one day. So how to kind of combat those things, article outline. So real quick, I'm gonna share some things. Just to handle the elements, the weather, make sure you take time for a walk. If we can bundle up and go to a tailgate party, you know, in normal times, we can bundle up and go for a walk. There are a lot of great trails and things just in the Appleton area. Grab some snowshoes or some skis and just get outside and get some fresh air, bundle up, wear a mask, and maybe go with a friend if that's something you can do safely and comfortably together, okay? And also make sure you get that vitamin D, that sunshine when it comes out. Yesterday, I know I saw the sun peeking out mid-afternoon and I was in the middle of a project and I thought, you know what, I need to go outside and at least take a 10-minute walk just to get some of that vitamin D in and just to feel that fresh air. And I realized how much better I felt when I got home from that walk. So make sure you take advantage of the sun when it's out. Even if it's just, like I said, a short 10-minute walk, get that burst of energy and fresh air. If you have nothing to look forward to, right? Like a lot of us had vacations postponed, a lot of us had parties postponed, a lot of us had big things over the past year that we had to cancel. Now's the time, start planning for the future, even just putting it on the calendar and starting to plan those details, even if it's still a year from now when hopefully things are a little more safe. Just putting it on the calendar can make it exciting and something to look forward to, and it gives you something to do to kind of help break up that monotony of your day-to-day routine. And then lastly, I love Christmas. I actually just took down my Christmas tree yesterday because I love the joy that that tree and those lights bring me. So if you're missing some of those festive holiday traditions that you have, take elements of those and incorporate them into your everyday life. I love the smells of kitchens of baking with nutmeg and cinnamon, all those fun holiday spices. So now I have candles that I light that have those similar scents. So again, it gives me the feel of the holidays without having to have all the muss and fuss of baking, right? I'm not a baker. If you love to bake, bake just because. You know, maybe you make a box of treats to leave on your neighbor's doorstep and brighten their day, and that also helps you feel better. So those are just a few of my quick tips for self-care. As we're in this new year and facing these long days, I just encourage you to do what you can to take care of yourself and to find joy in every day. See you later.